shove at her feet was a fortune's man. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might find. Saying we're gonna bend after station. If we don't, we're gonna blow a 50-amp fuse. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. Will you just find fun? You get what you need. Oh, baby, yeah. Oh, I went down to the Chelsea drugstore to get your prescription filled. I was standing in line with Mr. Jimmy. Man, did he look pretty ill? We decided that we would have a soda. My favorite flavor, cherry red. I sung my song to Mr. Jimmy. Yeah, and he said one word to me, and that was fair. I said to him, you can't always get what you want. It just might find. You get what you need. Oh, yeah.
You know that Courtney Love blogs, like, not blogs, I shouldn't say she blogs. She sits at home on her computer and makes videos and, you know, talks to people.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because, you know, I haven't figured out how to do that yet, nor will I. I don't think I'm going to ever do that. I can honestly tell you that, but.
She, like, has the cam on herself and.
Yeah, well, it seems that on Fashion Police with Joan Rivers and Kelly Osbourne, they implied she was a crack addict.
I think Kelly made some kind of
I'll play it for you.
Joke about drugs.
And then so Courtney Love got on her computer and posts stuff. I don't even know how she knows how to do that because.
Very computer savvy.
Yeah. Anyway, so she was offended and right there in her home. I don't know where she lives even. Is she in the city or is she? I think she lives here.
She has lived here. I've seen her, you know, out in Manhattan a few times.
Right. Yeah. And because when I went to that movie the other night where I sat behind Lindsay Lohan, supposedly she was supposed to show up, and I heard she shows up like 15 minutes before the movie ends. Like, it's a weird, like, she just does
right,
that
she can't make the movie.
No. Like, she, why would you want to see the last 15 minutes of a film? Especially a film that's good, like the one I saw with Jake Gyllenhaal.
Mm-hmm.
But, anyway, Here's Kelly Osbourne. Here's what she said.
It feels very safe to me. Like, she looks very safe.
You're talking about Courtney Love.
I like my Courtney Love either, like, gorgeous, like, stunning, where we're like, wow, look at Courtney Love, or just cracked up out of her mind. Like, do you know what I mean? Can I say that?
Yeah.
Does she do crap?
Probably. Oh. Allegedly.
What are you, old lady?
Is that when you're like, does she do crap?
Like, we know.
I just think that I can totally know, probably. I don't know.
All right, so Kelly Osbourne said, so then Courtney Love got on her computer to fire back.
The question is, how long?
It's like dark. It's like she's
slumped. No lighting.
No light, nothing. It's great. She's the best.
The question is, how long have I been sober? Well, if you listen to, this is fighting with the guy that runs the site. This girl I know, Kelly Osbourne, I've saved her life twice. The answer is since 05, since October 05. Physically, CPR, you know, putting things into her boobs, whatever, Oxycontin and Coke, foaming in the mouth. And 2 days
ago... You never know quite what she's saying, but it's still a fascinating train wreck, right?
Yeah.
It's great. I saved her life.
Twice.
How many? That would be big news if you saved somebody's life twice. Don't
I mean, usually these people don't announce when they're saving friends from ODs.
Ted Kennedy couldn't get the girl out of the car. Courtney Love was able to save Kelly Osbourne. Dr. Courtney Love was able to save Kelly Osbourne twice. Something about Oxycontin in the boobs.
Yeah.
Like, what does that mean? Oxycontin in the boobs. I realize how I'd have no career if I talked like that. If I just, like, never explained anything, I just said to you, yeah.
Just throw it out. Oxycontin in the boobs.
Oxycontin in the boobs, and then we go, like, what?
My sister texted me and said that Kelly Osbourne and Joan Rivers called me a crackhead on the E-Channel, and Kelly knows I've been sober, and Kelly knows there's no drugs allowed at my house. I think it's really lame. I think it's really, really, really lame. I'm eccentric. I wear wacky fucking hats, and sometimes, you know, I watched my drummer's documentary. I'm eating cookies and wearing red eyeshadow. Other than Adderall, which was a bit of a failed experiment that I'm no longer on, and I take a drug called Sonata, which is a cousin of Ambien, but you don't wake up with Eggs Benedict on one side of your face and you know, chocolate.
What does that mean? And chocolate.
I guess you don't sleepwalk when you're on this other one.
But she doesn't explain anything. You don't walk around with scrambled eggs on your face.
So that must have happened to her.
I take Ambien. You know what? First of all, I'm generally laying in bed when I take it because I'm trying to sleep. And
you're not trying to go do something?
Yeah, right. I don't try to stay up so I can experience the high.
Cake on the top of your head and a 100,000-word letter to someone you barely know about some obsessive love affair that you barely have. So Ambien is just...
I really like her. Uh-huh. But I got to tell you, she has no idea how boring that is. You know, you can't just ramble on.
Right. I mean, she's got an interesting life.
Yeah.
She can't talk about it interestingly.
No. She's willing to talk about it. You just got to decipher what the fuck she's saying.
Because I can make I can connect the dots.
Right. Sort of.
Well, she had this experience with a boyfriend where she was writing him all these letters and stuff, and she's making references to things that have actually happened.
How'd you get that? Where's my comprehension on all of this?
Okay, and it's supposed to be non-narcotic. It's just bad. It's a Sonata. I have a problem with sleeping. I take Sonata. I take Abilify, which I take a very, very low dosage. Don't let anyone trick you into taking 5 milligrams or above. You'll get something called akathisia, which is where you start to feel... like you don't belong in your body. And
wait, what happened to Kelly Osbourne?
What happened to being drug free?
Yeah, I'm hearing enough drugs to fill a suitcase.
Abilify is not being able to speak. You know, I have a large vocabulary. If I've taken too much Abilify, which is non-narcotic, say it's a neurological mood stabilizer, but there's some really heavy side effects to it. So I take 2 milligrams every 3 days. I take them literally like you would take a Valium. Like if I'm really depressed or bummed out, that's how I take them. But
we're all
born to say, when she knows perfectly well that I've been sober, she's going to be sober in my house.
That was the worst sober argument I've ever heard. Oh, my God.
That's funny.
A sober means you take nothing. Nothing more.
No, you're wrong.
Oh, wow.
You're being too literal.
Literally. I know a lot of Americans who say literally.
Well, that isn't that the English. Mary McCormick thing?
Mary says literally?
I thought you said that once.
Sometimes she does. But she gets a pass because she played my wife in the movie. She's pregnant.
Again?
Well, yeah, but I mean, like, in a big way. Like, she's about to give birth, I think.
How many kids has she had?
Pounded out. She's got, boy, I never thought she would be so maternal. She's got, this is her third.
Wow.
I heard from her the other day. Sometimes I don't hear from her for months, and then we email each other, like, frantically, and then we don't talk.
And then you drop off again.
Yeah. I know what you think. It's a white baby. I know you always ask me off the air. On the air,
I don't know what she's up to.
It's a white
baby. She's in that New Mexico or someplace for several months of the year.
It's a Mexican baby. It's a New Mexican baby. No, she's pregnant. Her husband, is doing quite well. He works on that show with Calista Flockhart. He's a
brothers and sisters.
He's the producer or the writer of it, or both. I don't know. He's told me 20. He's a great guy. Mm-hmm. I like him very much. And they're having another kid. And I keep tabs on her. I'm going out to LA. I'm going to hope to see her.
Good. Well, that's a big family she's raising.
Yeah. I think she would have preferred to have married me, but I was, not available.
The timing was wrong.
I'm sure, I hear about these actors, they fall in love on set. I'm sure she was in love working with me. I mean, who wouldn't be? I mean, all that making out and stuff, she probably had tremendous fantasies. She couldn't act on them, of course.
I think you broke up a relationship.
Yeah. I think she was falling in love with me during the movie, but she knew I was taboo. It was pretty evident.
That made it all the more exciting.
Yeah.
Unavailable.
She really needed it, but I couldn't, of course, give it to her. Having myself been in a marriage and was making a movie about how good my marriage was.
Right. You couldn't really make out with her with that being the theme.
I should have had a clue. Maybe things weren't so good that I was making out with Mary McCormick in every scene in the movie.
Even you didn't understand.
I didn't even know the things were falling apart. But unfortunately, she only played my movie wife. If I was an animal, I would have banged her on set.
Well, I remember that conversation where she said, it would have been just really too ridiculous if she had played your wife and then became your wife.
Why? Crocodile Dundee got away with it.
And how ridiculous is it?
No one heard from him again. He was drummed out
Everybody
of the business.
Everybody said, he's crazy.
He's a crazy motherfucker. He was on that Crocodile Dundee. Married long time. He got in that movie with that chick, whatever her name is.
Linda Kowalski.
Kowalski. And he ran off with her. I think that would have been great if I married. Like, I was in my movie. I fell in love with my movie wife.
And left your wife.
Left my wife and married my movie wife. How fucking beautiful is that? I would be Hollywood.
Oh,
Richard Burton.
Goodness.
Yeah. Too bad I couldn't get her to go along with it.
But Richard Burton wasn't playing himself and talking about how much he loved his wife in a movie.
Would have been great. Like, I started making love to Mary McCormick. Let's say she was really into me, which evidently she wasn't. But, I think she liked me as a friend. But let's say that she couldn't control herself. She seduces me. I become her lover. And then I say, look, I must be with you. I don't care. And I said, right, do you really think we'll be the laughing stocks of the world? And she's insane and goes, oh, absolutely not.
People understand.
People will understand we fell in love on the set. But I was playing your wife and about your good marriage. It would have been a great scandal. Well, I would have had a scandal.
Oh, my God. The tabloids would have loved that story.
Even better if I started dating one of the little kids who played my kids in the movie.
Well, that's the Woody Allen
thing. Yeah, that's the real way to go. It's funny with that Woody Allen. Everyone goes, well, he's an artist. So,
I know.
He's an artist. Like, if there was a guy living two doors down that was saying to your 16-year-old daughter, come over and visit me.
But he didn't make movies?
You'd have him arrested immediately. Women like the artist thing, Even their moms are okay with it. It's crazy
shit. She's justifying everything. Oh, I was a mature 16.
All right, here's a nice laugh for you. Sal and Richard called a radio show the other day. The announcer... At first, I thought it was going to be a tradio, but I don't think this is tradio because he doesn't sound like a tradio guy. But he immediately knows Sal and Richard.
Really?
Yeah, he knows what's going on.
I was sitting here on the air. Who are we talking to? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Cuz, how are you?
Who's this?
This is Fred Norris. Listening to you online, Cuz.
You're listening to us online?
Yeah, sir.
Well, Fred Norris. I don't know Fred. I think I'm going to move on, buddy. I didn't trust that guy. Sounded like a Howard Stern guy. Yeah, I'm serious. They can go prank somebody else. I just sent you on the air. Who are you talking to? Where are you calling from?
Yeah, it's
Steve from Kenosha. What's going on, Lenny?
Not much,
I'm
Steve.
I'm glad you hung up. That guy was from Stern, that idiot.
Yeah,
you guys good.
Yeah, it's, I mean, you know, they're morons. Go talk about somebody washing their junk or something.
Exactly.
Well, you're a bonehead.
Exactly.
Although I wouldn't mind Stern's $500 million.
Yeah, yeah.
So go ahead.
Speaking of junk, how big's your pepper?
Yeah. Hey, I'm having fun because you morons are all sitting online here, and I'm not going to answer any of your calls, and you can sit there forever and ever and ever, okay? Believe me, I've been in this situation before. Every